Good afternoon, everybody. Today, I would like to share about the topic you rose at the AGL Soda Solution. So first of all, I would like to have a small introduction about this topic. And as you may know that in our smartphone or laptop, it's always update automatically the newest software release version from the manufacturer. So I think we should apply the same one for the AGL or our embedded device. And that is the reason why we investigate to try to implement the software update for the AGL system. And today I come here to share with you the our result up to now and start. First of all, I would like to introduce about myself. And my name is Thu Nguyen, and I work for Renaissance Design Vietnam, and currently my task in Yokto project. And about Renaissance Design Vietnam, it's same with Thuy Trần presentation before, so I would like to skip. And about my agenda, it's here 5 main parts, and I would like to start to the short introduction about the software over the air in automotive industry. And first of all, we are going to find some reason why in automotive industry needs software updates. And actually it has many reasons, but today I just bring 3 main reasons. The first one is fixing issue timely. The second one is software update will help us to update our security system as soon as possible and can prevent the attacks from hacker. And the third one, it will support to more future for our device. So imagine that if you have the car or the embedded device and instead of every time you want to update the software, you bring this device to the shop, now you can stay at home or anywhere who can contact with the internet, and you can allow and update the newest packet. So because the new technology and new solution will be released every day and increase the complexity of the system, so the software update in vehicle is the hot topic. And next is about the software over the air. This is the technology to enable for fix, maintain, and improve the vehicle through the remote software update and download from the global server. And this is the basic SOTA architecture. As you can see that it has 3 main parts. The first one is the example that you have the new software packet and you want to update it in the current device. So the first one you engineer here will send the newest update packet to the management dashboard, and this will verify the correct version and send the packet to the internet. Yeah. We have the SOTA system, and it will manage, authorize, and deploy and download this update, and then send it to the device. On our device, it will also have the client, and it will provide the protocol and controller, and downloader and installer, and it will have to install the newest update packet to our device. And so you can see the important thing of the software update. And currently in our community, we also have many tools can support the software update. And here is the comparison table to see that compare the different advantages of this tool. And I compare based on 3 main conditions. The first one is update what can the software update do box update and the update mechanism and the action when the update fails. And as you can see here, when the comparison with 3.4 software update tool, we see that Rose is the most compatible and flexible for the automotive device. It can update everything with an update table, and it also support rollback when the system update fail. And so it is the reason that we focus to use this tool in the our demonstration. And then the next thing I would like to introduce a little bit that about the update what in here. We say that Rose can update everything, and everything here it was is for main bus. As in the embedded device, we have four main parts for updates. It is bootloader, kernel, and refresh system and application. And from top to bottom, it will easier to update application, always easier to update than bootloader, as you may know. And next, I would like to share a little bit more detail about Rose. This is the update framework and provide for basic tasks. And first, it generate the update artifact. The secondly, it will signing and verification the update packet. And it will help to store the security of update packet. And the third one is a robot installation handling. And the final, it will interface with the boot process. And in the roles, there are many scenarios to update the software, and there are four main scenarios. And as you can see on the official website of roles, and there are two main methods: it is symmetric and asymmetric. Another method is also implemented based on this. So I will focus to introduce about symmetric and asymmetric. First of all, about the symmetric update. In the symmetric update, our system will have four bus. And we will have two partitions have the same size. We will have the two main OS. And symmetric is the most common setup. And we will have two root partitions, one EAT and one EINAT. And after that, the ATOS will check the update packet from the SOTA server. If SOTA server says, hey, there are a new update packet, and the main OS will download it into this, and then install the update packet to the INATOS here. After install, it will reboot and switch the ATOS. Now here, main OS B is the AT and it will be updated, and we will working with the environment which will update it. So this symmetric has the main advantage. It is easy to understand from end user and easy to understand technical. And the update can start when running either slot. It also has a disadvantage. It is that we must have the big storage enough to store two main OS at the same time. So because of this advantage, we will have the asymmetric update method. In this, we also need two OS, but we just need a small OS. It is recovery OS, and it's small enough to fit into RAM. So we have just only have one main OS in here. And the main OS is active now, and it will checking the update from SOTA server. And also, if it has the new update package, it will download the update to the user data here. And then the system will reboot, and it will boot from the recovery OS. Now system will work from here. And system recovery OS will start to trigger and update and install the update package to the main OS. And then it's reboot again. And reboot again as quick back boot from the main OS in here. And now we working with the environment with the header update package. And next chapter, I would like to share about our current result when apply Rose and AGL. This is how we install Rose to AGL environment. AGL also have many layers, so we in the we download the meta Rose and install the it's in the DB layer config of the our environment and just add this line on the local config file. And the second one is the notice for the configuration and setting. First, we must generate the key and certification. And we already had this the script in this link. We just need to go to this link and run the script. And it will generate our key and certification. And we put it in our system. And it will have to verify and identify whenever the newest packet will update. And as previous part, I also introduced about symmetric and asymmetric. And if we want to config this, we just need to modify in the config file. Symmetric, we will define that slot is root 0 and root 1. But in asymmetric, we define two slots, one slot in recovery and one slot in main. And the next part, the next important that we need to switch OS, where because that you can see that after we update the new packet, we must reboot the system and switch to the OS which has the update packet. So we must define the method to auto switch OS. And we just for the short introduction, we just need to create the U-boot script, follow this thing, and then make some modification to config compatible with your current system, with your board, and then convert it to U-boot script and make it become the U-boot environment. And every time you reboot, it will automatically change the U-boot variable and update to the correct OS. And next, part 1 and part 2, I introduce about how to install Rose in the system. And next, I will introduce how to set up SOTA. It means that we have this is for the client. And this is for the server. We just need to follow this link. And it is the Docker image. And after we start successfully, we will have the Hybrid Server GUI like this. And we will control and deliver the update packet using this server. And this is short introduction about our demonstration. Because up to now we just implement in the symmetric way. And our target device is the static board. And our environment is AGL GG 7.0.0. And our target will update from the AGL image minimal to AGL demo platform. And we also had two OS. One is bottom is image minimal, and one is NFT and one is NFT. The NFT will trigger the update from the SOTA server. It is the AGL demo platform file system, and it will download it to this OS. And after that, it will install to the OSB. And the OSB here will become the AGL demo platform. after it's done successfully. And then we reboot the system, and the system will automatically switch. And now we will work on the AGL demo platform. And here is the demonstration. This is the image about our demonstration. This is the M3 starter kit board. This is the SOTA server, and this is the laptop to control the board. And this is the video. Okay. And this is the video of the demonstration. This is the SOTA server. And we will create the robot if we had a new bucket update. And this is about the AGL. And we had the, in the our system just one more. So it's in the, the habit server ongoing to send the signal to the board. And the board will start. Detect the new bucket and start to download this bucket. And after download successfully, it will start to install automatically to the another partition. Yeah. And after that successfully, we will have the result signal here. Then after that, I will reboot the board. And the board screen from minimal is no graphics. And after update and reboot successfully again, it will become the AGL demo with the display graphics. And next part is the conclusion. And our conclusion here is SOTA is important technical for the automotive industry. And we will continue to improve SOTA system using ROS. And our next plan will implement asymmetric module using the SOTA habit server client. And next, we will investigate how to update the bootloader using ROS. And we will shorten the time for download and install the bucket. And increase the automatically of the solution. And that's all for my presentation. Thank you for your listening.
Thank you, Nan. Okay, is there any questions and discussions?
Correct or not, and we'll compare with the key in the client, and if it match, it will start to install, and if it not match, it will reject and report the to the system that it had some wrong bucket and with no compatible.
Okay. Anything else? Okay.
Thank you for your presentation. I have one question about latest situation about this updating technology. Is there any? Is there any automobile company applying this OTA method already?
I'm sorry, I don't know about this information, but I just researched that currently many automotive companies are trying to develop their own update software system. So here I just try to introduce the easy way to support the software update in the automotive system. And about the specific company or a name of company, I don't know.
Thank you.
Okay. Maybe you can speak up.
Thank you for the presentation. I have a question about the functionality of the rollback.
Yeah,
in the page 11.
Yeah, okay.
When you compare the existing approaches, the rollback failure,
Resident
mentioned about rollback.
Yes.
And for example, the software update, SW update in the right side in this table, it said no recovery mechanism is built in.
Yes.
So, but I'm not sure about the detail of the array you see. Functions about the rollback. So, what is the difference of these two? In my understanding, the SW update also has the rollback functions available also with the SW update. For example, by setting some watchdog to the bootloader. The system, when the system hangs, it's automatically rebooted, and you would also can detect the update failure. So I'm interested in the functionality of the rollback in the
array. Please wait a moment. I will show you the image of the. We will have the boot variable. I will explain more about the mechanism of rolls in here. Sorry, it kind of blur. When draw finish the updating here, it will change the update variable. You see the bootloader here, it mentioned about B and A. B here is B and A is the main OS, main OS B and main OS A. Bootloader is the priority of the boot. It B here is mean that after updating the solution, the system will choose B as the first priority and boot from the OSB. If the rows update will fail, it will not update the boot order here, and we still stay in the OS which is stable. Sorry, let me explain again. If update successfully, row will change the boot variable in here. This is the boot environment variable, and it will tell that the system boot from the update OS. But if the system update will fail, row will not update the boot variable in here. And when we reboot, the system still stay in the OSI. It means that if update fail, it will not host for the current system. The current system still here. And we still work with the XAML in here. We still work with the AGL minimal bucket in the OSI. No switch to the OSB. It means the row, it's either rollback functional.
So in this case, if the update failed, the system is booted with the OSA.
Yes, the OSA.
And then the system can detect the update was failed because the boot parameter is not updated.
Because that when update failed, Row will inform to the console that the update will fail. And it will not change the boot environment. And it will keep at the first as before updating. And we still working normally with the OSI in here.
I see. So does it mean that the update system assumes that the system updated system always can be booted or not? I'm not sure.
We must reboot to see the effect of the system, and we must reboot here to change the OS. So if the update fails, the boot variable not change. We reboot, it will not affect to all the systems.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, something else? Is it all right for everybody? Yeah. Thank you very much.